Welcome to Orange Roots lesson number 6. This is our special composition lesson. So we're actually going to be spending most of our lesson right here in Composer's Corner.
Yes, I'm so happy to see you get to compose your piece.
And we're so glad that Edison is going to be here to help us with this today. Did you know that the word compose actually means to put together? And that's what we're going to get to do today. Isn't that right, Edison? And you can compose because you know all the parts of music. Should we do a quick review of the parts of music that we know? Stand up with me for just a minute. You know all about time signatures. This is our 3/4 time signature. Say that. 3/4 time signature. And how many beats does it get in each measure? Help me out. Lollipop. 1, 2, 3. This is our 4/4 time signature. Say it with me. 4/4 time signature. It gets how many beats in each measure? 4. Can we pat our watermelon? 1, 2, 3, 4. You know about bar lines. Can you say that word with me? Bar lines. And we know that this makes measures. Say that word with me. Measures. We know at the end of a song, we have a double bar line. Say it with me. Double bar line. It means to stop. You got it. And sometimes we see a repeat sign. Say that with me. Repeat sign. What do we do when we see a repeat sign? Dot, dot. Do it again. Repeat, repeat. You got it. You know all sorts of different ways that you can play music. Piano. Say that word with me. Piano. What do we say for this one? Forte. Say it with me. Forte. We know to play loud on that one. What should we do on this? Is it our legato? Say it with me. Legato. We know to play smooth on that one. Or our staccato. Can you say it with me? Staccato. We know to play our notes short and detached on that one. You know major. Can you say major with me? And you know minor. Can you say minor with me? You know lots of rhythms. Do you think you could clap this one with me? Here we go. Beetle bug, beetle bug, shoot the caterpillar bug. Wow. And you know all about your chords. Can you sing with me? Do is the root of the red chord. Fa is the root of the blue. So is the root of the yellow chord. And this is always true. You know how to play your chords in different ways. You could play them block. You could play them marching. You could play them broken, like in Cockles and Muscles. You also know how to play variations. You even know how to play inversions on chords, like in Old Paint. You know how to give musical answers to musical questions, where the music answer feels like the question and it ends on do. You have listened to so many great composers like Mozart and Beethoven, who have put even more musical ideas into your head. And you even know how to write music down onto paper. That was a fun review. Since we're back in Composer's Corner now, I want to introduce you to some of my composer friends. They were students in Let's Play Music just like you.
Oh, I remember some of their compositions. Let's take a closer look.
Would you like to see how some of my friends started writing their compositions?
Yes, let's do that.
Let's take a look. This is how my friend Macy Musical started her composition. She's 6 years old. Macy started with a melody. That's the tune that you can sing. Her story was about an ice cream truck. She loves ice cream trucks. Macy started with a rhythm that she really liked. What rhythm do you think that that was? Can you see our shoot the bug bug rhythm in her composition? She also liked baby steps and skips. She chose to play in C major and in 4/4 time. Let me play this for you. Do you hear her? Shoot the bug, bug. Do you hear the rhythm? Shoot the bug, bug. It's not really a song, but it's a start. And that's exactly what Edison and I want you to do. We want you to just start.
Yes, Macy started with just a rhythm. I quite like that rhythm of shoot the bug, bug.
Yeah, that is a fun rhythm. Here's another example of how one of my friends chose to start their composition. This is Stockton Staccato, and he is 8 years old. His story was about a basketball game. Stockton started with chords. He really likes chords in root position, and he really liked staccato notes. Can you hear how the ball is bouncing in his piece? He chose C major and 4/4 time. Let me play it for you.
The staccatos.
I did too. Now Stockton, when he started off, already started writing for both hands. You don't have to do this. Macy didn't start writing with both hands. But if you know what you want for both of your hands, you can go ahead and start adding that right now.
So Stockton started with chords and then he changed the rhythm in the second measure. Oh yes, I see that he also likes that bug beetle slug pattern. He used those twice.
He did use that rhythm. He knew his chords and he knew what rhythm he wanted to use. That's so fun. Here's another friend. This is Alyssa Allegro. She is 7. Her story was about a butterfly. She wanted to play lots of glissandos. Do you remember what a glissando is? When we play up, up, or we played down. She loved those. And she only wanted to play black keys. That's why there are so many sharps in her key signature. Listen to Alyssa's piece. Alyssa started with just her melody notes too, just like Macy.
The way it's sounding already.
She wanted her tune to sound like a butterfly. Does it kind of sound like a butterfly already? Can you see what rhythm she used? She used beetle, beetle, slug.
That's a good rhythm. I like that one too.
And then she did that rhythm 4 different times, but started on different notes each time she played that rhythm. Alyssa only has melody notes right now, but this is such a great start.
Yes, I really like this one. I can't wait to hear what happens to the butterfly.
Here's another friend I want to show you. This is Garrett Grandstaff. His story was about monsters. He really wanted his piece to be in C minor, and he wanted to start with chords. He thought that the minor chords in the bass clef playing lots of quarter notes sounded like scary monsters stomping around. He chose the melody notes in the right hand out of the chords that he was playing in the left hand. Listen while I play. Do you hear the chords stomping in the left hand? I could tell Edison liked dancing to that one.
Yes, that was a fun one. So Garrett started with chords, and then he added his melody to match the chords.
That's exactly right, Edison. This time he started with chords, not the melody. That's just another fun way that you could start your composition. My last friend didn't know how to start. Her name is Alexa Andante, and she is 7 years old. Her story was about her cat, Mittens. But she didn't have any chords in mind, and she didn't have a melody in mind, and she didn't even have a rhythm. She didn't know how to make it sound like her cat. So she put her hand in C position, and she just played 4 notes. Do you know what notes she played? She played C, D, E, D. And she decided she liked the sound of just those 4 notes so much that she played them again. She played them 4 times. C, D, E, D. Third time, C, D. She thought that Mittens moved so fast, so she decided to make those notes beetles. And then she decided that she should put her hand in treble C position because those notes would be higher and sound more like Mittens. Listen to what that sounds like. And then she imagined that Mittens might step down and move around again. And it sounds like this. Then she decided that her left hand could sound like she sounds when she's playing with her cat. Since she usually likes to start with a red chord, she wanted to use the notes from a red chord, but decided she just wanted to play the outer notes, kind of like Hickory Dickory Dock. So she played the 5th, and here's how her piece sounded. Now, Alexa's piece wasn't finished.
No, but it's such a good start.
Yes, they all had a good start. In fact, none of my friends' songs were finished, but they have lots of time to finish them, and so do you. You get to work on your composition and make it be what you want to be. Your job is to write down or record at least 4 measures of music to take to your teacher. They will then help you put it onto the computer and notate it for you so that you can start to play it. You start playing it over and over and decide what you want to do it from there. So let's take a look at your story. Do you feel like your story is going to be major or minor? Do you feel like it will be fast or slow? Do you think it'll be in 3/4 or 4/4? Do you think it'll be legato or staccato? You get to decide right now. When the screen pauses, I want you to look through and tell your grown-up which pieces and parts of the music you think you want to include in your story. Great! Now you need to decide how you will begin. Do you already have a melody you're thinking of? Do you already have chords you're thinking of? Do you already have a rhythm that you're thinking of?
There are so many ways you can start your composition. It's so exciting.
It is exciting. And to help you, we have created 3 supplemental videos. There's one on melody, there's one on rhythm, and there's one on chords. You and your grown-up can decide which ones you want to use. You can watch them all if you want, or if you already know you want to start with a certain one, just watch that one. You can do that at another time. For now, since we have a little more time, I think we should head back to music class.
Yes, that was so fun. I can't wait to see what you do, but head on out to music class and I'll see you next time.
Okay, we'll see you next time, Edison. I can't wait for you to work on your composition this week. Okay, can you open up in your books for me to page 7? I want to take a look at our C minor cadence. Do you see our C minor cadence there? It's the 3rd line down. Where do we need to put our hand to play our C minor red chord? Do you remember which finger needs to play the black key? It's the three finger in the middle. Can you play the block chord with me? Here we go. Yes. Do you have that flat key with your three finger on the E flat in the middle? And you can see our book is helping us out by reminding us that the E is flat. But it doesn't need to, because over here it's telling us that our E will be flat. Let's break up that block chord into its pieces. Help me out, here we go. Yes. Okay, should we play our minor blue chord? Which note has a flat in the blue chord? It's the top note. So let's slide till our pinky can play the A flat. Yes, can you play that block chord with me? Here we go. There's that minor blue. Can we break it up into its pieces? Bottom, middle, top. Let's come back to our minor red chord. Look at that. It doesn't look like that flat is there anymore, but it is because of our key signature. So let's go ahead and play our minor red chord again. Can you play the block chord with me? And then let's break it up into its pieces. Yes, and then our yellow chord. He's easy. We don't have to worry about any black keys. Go ahead and play the yellow chord the way you've always played it. There's our yellow. And then back to our minor red chord. Can we break that one into its pieces one last time? Do, me, so. That's so fun. I love minor sounds. I'm excited that we know how to play our C minor cadence. Mr. Rabbit, can you tell what song he wants us to play? Can we open up to Cockles and Muscles on page 12? Now today, I think we should do something a little bit different. I think we should try to play the chords in the left hand broken. We've already written in what all of the roots are, so we'll just have to put our five finger on those notes and then play it broken. Do you want to try this with me? So I'm going to float my bubble hand into C position, making sure I'm ready to be able to play each of the roots. We drew in the roots, so we'll know what to play. Are you ready to play this with me? Just our left hand, broken chord. What's the first one? C, E, G, break it up. C, E, G, move up to D. D, F, A, break it up. D, F, A, move up to E, break it up. How you doing? Do another one. E, E, G, move up to F, break it up. And then move up to G. G, break it up. Nice job! Wow! That was fun to play the left hand broken. Now, I know that you have been practicing hands together. Have you started trying hands together with the block chord in the left hand? Could we try hands together with that broken chord together? I want to look at just the first line of this. Our hands will start playing together on the downbeat of Dublin's, but our right hand gets to start us out with that G. I'm going to play it first so that you can see what my hands are doing, and then I'll have you join me. In Dublin's fair city, where? Did you see how my left hand was playing broken chords while I played the notes in the right hand? I want you to try this with me. Are both hands in C position? Since we're playing on the upbeat, we're going to be starting on three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Let's do it again. That was tricky. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Let's try it one more time. I love it when we can work sections of our songs line by line or measure by measure. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Does that feel different in your hands to have that broken chord in the left hand? Now, you can choose. If you want, you could keep trying to play the broken chords in the left hand, or you could keep trying the block chords, but I do want you to try to work hands together on this one this week. That'll be so much fun. Thanks, Mr. Rabbit, for helping with my outfit. Can you look at the very next song in our book? And what do you see? John Jacob Jingleheimer Smith. Have you been playing the two-handed marching chord? I love playing this. Have you been playing it with beetles? Have you tried to do a caterpillar? Let's take a look at the very first chord. We already know it's a F, so we have our F in the left hand, and we will play our F chord in the right hand. Here we go. F chord, F chord. Do you hear the one, two, three, four? Yes. What about the next two measures? We're going to have a C in the root in the left hand, and we will be playing the yellow chord in the right hand. Could we try these ones as beetles? One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and keep going. One and two and three and four, and we get to play two full measures of that. Ooh, we are back to our F chord. That was an easy one. Do you think we could try to do our caterpillars with this one? Caterpillar, caterpillar, here we go. Caterpillar, 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 cater. Keep going. One, two, three, four. Are there four caterpillar marching chords in each chord to do that? That's so fun. Should we try the, ooh, what should we do on the blue chord? We have a B flat in the left hand. Can you put your hand on the blue chord in the right hand? What should we try? Should we go back to just do our bugs? One, two, three, four, here we go. One, two, three, four, bug, 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 bug. That's so much fun. Let's keep going. Have our C in the left hand and our yellow chord in the right hand. Should we do this one, beetle? Beetle, 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 help me out. C chord, C chord, C chord, C chord, yes. And on the very last measure, this is the one time that we don't have a full four beats. These aren't whole notes anymore. These are half notes. So we could play our F chord two times, and then we could play our yellow chord two times. That would be so fun. Should we try this with our track? We could try to play it with bugs the first time through, and when we do the dot, dot, do it again, we could try it with our beetles. Make sure your hand is ready in F position. Are you ready? Here we go. F. F. Here's our C. One, two, three, four. Back to F. Two, three, four. Here's another F. Two, three. Oh, here's the blue with the B flat. Three. Back. Yellow. And then F. Dot, dot. Do it again. Can you try the beetles? C. Beetle, 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 beetle. Back to the F. Here's another F. Beetle, beetle, beetle. Oh, here's the blue. Beetle, beetle. And the yellow. Beetle, beetle, F. And then C. And you could dot, dot, do it again and keep going if you wanted. That's so fun. Maybe on your own, you could even start practicing the caterpillar. It gets really fast. Make sure you can do the two-handed marching as a bug first before you try to speed it up. Okay, I think it's time. Should we sneak off to our puppet show and see what's going on with our game of hide and seek? Be so quiet so we don't mess them up. I'll see you there. We made it back to our swamp. Can you stand up with me today? You and your grown-up. Do you think we could do all the actions without our puppets? This will be so fun. Who's first? Did you hear them at the same time? You hear our dragon? Do you hear? You hear the ghost floating in the air? What about? Can you hear Frankenstein? Can you hear him? The ghost is still floating. Can you hear the ogre and the dragon?
driving.
Do you hear the ghost again?
Do you hear Frankenstein? I still hear Frankenstein! Who's next?
Do you hear that ogre?
Are they happening at the same time?
That was fun doing it without our puppets. Let's sneak back to class. That was so fun. I love playing hide and seek with our monsters. I think it's time for my friend to come over. Come on over. Yay, Ruby came back. I think we should play point and pound today. Should we play point and pound together? Ruby, do you want to take a seat at our keyboard? We're going to put a note up on the board. And as fast as you can say it, you're going to then point and pound and play it and say it at the same time. You ready? We'll start with an easy one. Did you find it? Are you saying middle C, middle C, middle C, middle C at home? Ruby found it. Okay, hands up. Let's do another one. Let's try, what about this one? Do you think you know where it is at home? You and your grown-up can find it. Where is it? It is a B, and this is our B that's above middle C. Where would that be? Did you find the B above middle C? Can you? Yes! B, 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 B. Ruby found it. Let's do, should we do one in the bass clef? What about, what's that one? Do you know what that one is at home? It's a C, 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 C. Ruby found it. Did you find it? C, 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 C. Whoop! Let's do another one. Let's do another one in the bass clef. What about, let's do this one. What is that one? Do you think you know what it is? Do you and your grown-up find it? Ruby found it. It's F, 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 F. You and your grown-up can keep playing. You can either figure out notes or you could even flash a note in your deck and then name it and then point it and pound it as fast as you can. Thank you so much, Miss Ruby. You did such a great job at point and pound. Should we say goodbye to our friends?
Bye.
Thank you. I'll see you next time. That was so much fun. Let's say goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Let's say goodbye. I'll see you next week. Let's take a look at what our homework is for lesson number 6. You're going to get to do some of that fast counting like we were doing with our caterpillar, caterpillar, 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a. That'll be so much fun. You're going to show your teacher the notes you've been working on for your composition. Don't forget about your flashcards. They are so important. Work on the F major scale this week. C minor cadence. We got to play that together. Your inversions, magic keys. That's such a fun one. Make sure you're playing through that and singing. The lyrics on that one are so important. Cockles and muscles. Maybe you could try the broken chord in the left hand or just play the block. But start putting hands together on that one this week. John Jacob, have fun with that two-handed marching style. You get to choose however fast of a bug you want to play it. And don't forget about From a New World. We're still working part one and then starting on part 3. Thanks so much for playing with me. I'll see you next time.